Some cameras, when shooting video, let you switch between shutter speed and shutter angle. Shutter speed is what most of us are familiar with. The number on screen, such as 60 or 250, is a fraction. If we look at this camera, we'll see that we're at 1/60th of a second, that rolls to 1/80th, 1/100th, and so on. That's easy to understand. The exposure is that duration of time long. But if we change the camera to shutter angle mode by going to the image quality menu and then to SS gain operation and choosing angle/ISO, we now see our exposure time displayed as a number in degrees, which is a portion of a circle. This method of thinking goes back to the days of shooting movie film. The shutter on movie film cameras isn't a shutter like on an SLR camera that opens and closes. Instead, movie film cameras have a spinning disc with some size opening that acts as a shutter, allowing light through to the film behind it as the film flies by at, say, 24 frames per second. A disc that's half open and half solid is half of a 360-degree circle, or 180 degrees. As the disc spins at one full rotation per frame of film, if you're shooting at 24 frames per second and exposing for half the time, then you're exposing at 1/48th of a second. This half-duration exposure has come to be known as an ideal exposure, allowing a pleasing amount of motion blur without excessive smearing. If you need to shoot in lower light, you can open up to a 360-degree shutter, but you can't open any more. So if you're shooting at 24 frames per second, the lowest shutter speed you can possibly shoot at is 1/24th of a second. If there isn't any fast movement in the scene, well, this'll look fine. But if there is, it'll look smeary and kind of weird. If we're shooting in extremely bright light, we can shoot at a lower shutter angle, all the way down to 11 degrees, exposing for much less time. However, the visual result of this can be a stuttered image, and any fast movement will appear unnatural. This certainly can be used for effect, and often is in action movies, but for general purpose shooting, high and low shutter angles are best avoided. So what does all this have to do with the camera setting? After all, it's easy math to calculate the ideal shutter speed. If I'm shooting at 30 frames per second, shoot at 1/60th of a second. Shooting 50p, shoot 1/100th, and so on. But by putting your camera in a shutter angle mode and making a conscious selection of, say, 180 degrees, then you know that no matter what frame rate you're shooting at, 24, 25, 30, 50, 60, 120, your shutter speed will always be the ideal setting, exposed for half of the time. Many filmmakers like to shoot with shutter angle because as they change frame rates, they don't have to remember to change their shutter speeds as well. Plus, as they deliberately go for lower or higher shutter angles and then also change frame rates, they can make consistent changes, retaining a consistent look throughout their shoot, even as frame rates change. Also, it makes us feel like we know what we're talking about and that we're not just a bunch of hacks. Wait, was that my outside voice? If you can't adjust shutter angle or shutter speed to change exposure, then you have to change aperture or ISO or add neutral density filters. That's a topic for another video.